Good morning, children. Let's start with the decentralization topic today. Before this, we have gone with delegation. We have already discussed about the delegation topic of chapter number 5, organizing, where we have discussed that delegation is really important for the purpose of giving or handing over work to the subordinate. And when we talk about delegation, it is basically where superior is giving or sharing his work to his immediate subordinate. So there is always a confusion between these two terms, delegation or decentralization. So here you need to be careful that when we talk about delegation, जब हम delegation की बात करते हैं, delegation में क्या होता है? It is refers to the downward transfer of authority from superior to a subordinate, right? Means जो authority transfer हो रही है, authority means power, right? Decision making की power, जो transfer हो रही है, वो कैसे transfer हो रही है? Downward transfer हो रही है. How downward transfer? Superior is sharing his authority to whom? To his subordinate. And this is his immediate subordinate. Right? So here, delegation is not referred with the transfer of authority to the whole organization. यहाँ पे जो sharing होती है वो पूरी organization में नहीं होती है. सिर्फ किस में होती है? Immediate subordinate को होती है. Like suppose there are three people working into organizations. A, B, C. A is the boss. B is the subordinate. And then C. Right? So here, B is the immediate subordinate of A. So in case the organization is having delegation policy where the superior can share their some work with the subordinate which they need to do for the purpose of reducing their burden. So A will be sharing the work with his immediate subordinate, that will be B. So this process, right? So this is going to be called as your delegation. इसे हम क्या बोलेंगे? Delegation. Because downward transfer of authority has been done. And this was done by superior to its immediate subordinate. And the reason for this was just for sharing his work, just for reducing his burden. Right? So now we have already done about the delegations. In delegation, we have done about element of delegations. In the element of delegations, I have explained you about authority. The first element, a very important element of delegation, which say that it is the right of every individual to command his subordinate and to take action within the scope of his positions, right? So authority basically kya refer karta hai? Authority is referring about the power. That if, it's basically saying that every individual who is sitting in the position of top has a power to command his subordinate, and this is going to be called as authority, right? So it's basically can be also called as taking or right of taking decision also. Now the next element we have done was responsibility, where I'm just giving you a quick review of all those. I'm not going very deeply here. In responsibility, we have done that it is the obligation of a subordinate to properly perform the assigned duty. And this assigned duty was done by whom? It is done by the superior, right? So responsibility basically means obligation. Obligation of whom? Obligation of subordinate. Or for whom the subordinate is obligated? It is obligated to the superior for performing that task properly which was shared by him. Next is accountability. Now this is the third element of delegation. Delegation ka ek teesra element hota accountability, which basically say delegation of authority undoubtedly empower an employee to act for his superior, but the superior would still be accountable for the outcome. This is very important here, right? So you can understand accountability basically means answerability. It means if a superior has delegated his work to his subordinate, right? It is the responsibility of a subordinate to perform that work exactly the manner which superior has instructed him, right? So once that work is performed by the subordinate, still superior will be answerable in case there is anything goes wrong over there. So here what is happening here? Accountability basically saying that we are delegating the work, we are empowering the employee. Aapne power de di employee ko apne according kaam karne ki, but jo superior hoga वो स्टिल अकाउंटेबल होगा, आंसरेबल होगा उस रिजल्ट के लिए, उस आउटकम के लिए, राइट? सो हेयर वी कैन से अकाउंटेबिलिटी बेसिकली मीन्स बीइंग आंसरेबल फॉर द फाइनल आउटकम. सो दीज आर द थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट एलिमेंट ऑफ डेलीगेशंस. दैट वाज अथॉरिटी, सिंपली इफ यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड मीन्स पावर, पावर ऑफ टेकिंग डिसीजन. देन योर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी मीन्स ऑब्लिगेशंस टूवर्ड द सुपीरियर, एंड अकाउंटेबिलिटी मीन्स आंसरेबिलिटी.
right? So these are the three element of delegation. And delegation is what, children? Delegation is basically means where we are sharing our work downwards. To whom? To our immediate subordinate. And why we are doing this? This we are doing for the purpose of reducing our burden. Right? Now, next concept here is decentralization. Now, this is the topic which we have to start today, decentralization. Why I have gone with delegation is because most of the time the children get confused into delegation or decentralization. So, in simply you have to understand one thing, that there is always a difference between delegation and decentralization. How? In simple word you can say, delegation may, when we are handing over our power of decision making, we are doing that to our immediate subordinate, right? Like I have given you example of ABC, three people are working into three positions, A is top, then B and then C. If we are following a policy of delegation into organization, in that case A can only share his work to whom? To B. क्यों? क्योंकि B उसका क्या है? Immediate subordinate है, right? This is delegation, where the sharing of work or sharing of decision making power can be done to immediate subordinate towards downwards, right? But in case of decentralization, the difference here is that they can share, the authority can be shared with the lower level of organization also. It means we are not restricted towards only the immediate subordinate. जो top का है वो towards downwards to any organization level में अपने work को, अपनी decision power को क्या कर सकता है, share कर सकता है. So that concept is going to be called as decentralization. That is the reason we say delegation आपका क्या होता है, एक narrow concept हो गया, decentralization is a wider concept, right? Now let's start with decentralization actually है क्या. Now when we talk about decentralization, decentralization basically say that if there is any organization, it is completely a choice of a top management that what kind of organization policy they want to use, whether they want to go with a centralization policy or they want to go with a decentralization policy. So it is completely a choice of organization. Decentralization or centralization, two very important words are here. In your syllabus we only have decentralization, so we will not go very deep in centralization here, right? But these are called as relative terms. Centralization or decentralization relative term hai. Both are relate with each other. Organization is centralized when? When we say that decision making authority is retained with the higher management level only. Right? कोई भी ऐसी organization जहाँ पे decision making power जो होती हैं वो किसके पास होती हैं? सिर्फ high management की, यानी top management के पास में होती हैं. They are not sharing these powers to the downwards. So that organization will be going to be called as what? It is going to be called as centralized organization, right? So any organization where the decision making authority is retained with higher level of people is going to be called as centralized organization, right? Now just opposite of centralized organization, children, we have decentralized organization. Decentralized organization kya bolta hai? That an organization where we call decentralized means authority is delegated. It is, right? So it basically says ek organization jahan jo decision making power hai, that is retained with the higher people only, top people only, we say that organization is centralized organization. Or any organization where the decision making power is shared with, or their decision making power is delegated towards the downward also, to the lower level people also, we say that organization is a decentralized organization, right? Now when we need to decide that whether we have to follow the policy of centralization or we have to follow the policy of decentralization, we have to go with a lot of thing in our organizations. And the reason behind this is that no organization can be completely centralized and no organization can be completely decentralized. We need to have balance between the centralization and decentralization policy inside the organization. The reason behind there is that it is not possible from the top level to take all the decision making power, right? So they need to give, or they need to flow, or they need to delegate some of the powers to downward. So definitely they have to go with decentralization policy. But still, every power or every decision making power cannot be decentralized or cannot be delegated. because there are certain power which should be remained with the top people only. So there they need to go with the centralization. So what is happening here? We cannot go completely with a centralization policy, or we cannot go complete with a decentralization policy. We need to have a balance between centralization or decentralization inside any organization, because it is completely unrealistic to go with one term only, right? So here simply you need to understand centralization kya tha. Centralization basically say that way we are giving or decision making power we are retaining only with the higher management. जो decision making authority होती है वो delegate नहीं होती है, सिर्फ higher management के पास रहती है. That policy is going to be called as centralization. And decentralization is just opposite of it, where that authority is going to be delegated. जहाँ पर decision making के power आप delegate कर देते हो lower level को भी, share कर देते हो, downward flow कर देते हो, that is going to be called as decentralization. And conclusion here is that we need to have a balance of centralization and decentralization inside any organization for its smooth work, right? So now let's take the definition of decentralization here. Now when we talk about decentralization definitions, it's written decentralization refers to a systematic, just a minute children, so we are here. These are the definition of decentralization. Decentralization refers to systematic effort to delegate to the lowest level all authority except that which can be exercised at central point. So this is the first definition given by Lewis Allen. According to Lewis Allen, he said decentralization kya hai? Ye refer hota hai ek systematic efforts hai. Systematic effort of whom? Systematic efforts of top management. Where what they are doing? They are delegating the power. They are delegating the authority towards the lower level of management. But only few authority. They are keeping certain authority, those who are going to be a central point, those who are important with them only. So that is going to be called as decentralization. So hereby this Lewis Allen definition also you can understand that all the decision making authorities are not delegated to the lowest level. There are certain central point authority, central point decision making power which are always retained with the top management, right? Next definition was given by Henry Fayol, and what he say everything which goes to increase the importance of subordinate role is decentralization. Everything that goes to reduce it is going to be called as centralization. Now if you go and read this line properly beta, you will find here what is happening here. Everything which goes to increase the importance of subordinate is decentralization. How? According to Fayol, he is saying कि जो भी एक subordinate को role को increase करता है वो क्या कहलाएगा आपका? Decentralization कहलाएगा. How? Now you can say if we are following the decentralization policy in our organization, it means what we are doing? We are in a process of delegating our decision making power or authority to the lowest level also. So here we are giving more freedom to our lower level people, right, to work according to their own creative manner. Iski wajah se kya ho raha hai? Their importance are also increasing. So this is what he is saying here, ki what is going to increase the importance of subordinate is going to be called as decentralization. Decentralization mein when you are giving power, authority, delegating, you are delegating that authority to the downwards. It means you are increasing the importance of lower level of people also. Now next he is saying that everything that goes to reduce it is going to be called centralization. Or subordinate ki importance ko jo bhi reduce karega usse hum kya bolenge? Centralization. How? Because in centralization we are not giving any kind of authority, any kind of decision making power to the subordinate. They have to work according to the order exactly what has been given from the top management side. So what is happening? We are reducing their creativity. If they know better than if they have been given some work
and we have instructed them that this work is supposed to be done by this method. अगर उनके पास में उस काम को करने का better method है, but because the freedom is not given to them, right? The authority is not delegated to them. They will be not able to show their creativity. So what is happening here in the centralization? We are reducing their importance also, right? And we are reducing their role also. So according to this Henry Fayol definition, he say that everything in the organization which will increase the importance and role of subordinate is going to be called as decentralization, and which is going to reduce the role of subordinate is going to be called as centralization, right? So this is all about your decentralization and centralization, children. In the conclusion, I've already told you that it is not possible that an organization can never be completely centralized or decentralized, right? According to the sizes, according to its complexity, they need to go with decentralization, but they need to be stick with certain decision power they need to retain with themselves only, right? So now this was all about delegation and your decentralization also. Now let's start with the importance of decentralization. Decentralization ki, when we talk about the importance of decentralization, importance iski yahi se clear ho jayegi that it is much more than a mere transfer of authority to the lower level of management hierarchy. Why? Because when we talk about delegation, delegation mein humne kya kaha tha? Transfer of authority to the subordinate. Aur kyun kar rahe the? For the purpose of sharing a work to reduce the burden of top management. But in case of decentralization, we cannot define it just a transfer of authority to the lower level of management, but it is more than that, right? So what it is also called as a philosophy, right? Decentralization ko hum ek philosophy bhi bolte hain, and this philosophy is basically decision maker's need for autonomy, right? Ye philosophy kis liye hai? Decision making need ke liye banayi gayi thi, right? Let's see the advantage of decentralization. Now first advantage decentralization is saying is it develops the initiative among subordinate. Decentralization develop initiative among subordinate. And how? Because decentralization mein kya ho raha hai, we are helping or we are promoting self reliance and confidence among the subordinate. How? By handing over the work of top level to the down level. आप जो टॉप लेवल के जो वर्क हैं, जो अथॉरिटी है उसको डेलीगेट कर रहे हैं, डिसीजन पावर को डेलीगेट कर रहे हैं किसको? सबऑर्डिनेट्स को, डाउन लेवल टिल टू लोअर लेवल ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, वी आर ट्राइंग टू यू नो इंक्रीज ए कॉन्फिडेंस, वी आर ट्राइंग टू मेक देम सेल्फ रिलायंस सो दैट द वर्क विच दे आर डूइंग दे विल डू इट अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर ओन क्रिएटिव मैनर, राइट? सो द फर्स्ट एडवांटेज डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन डिड इज इट डेवलप इनिशिएटिव अमंग सबऑर्डिनेट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड दिस इन अ क्लास ऑल्सो. इफ यू हैव बीन गिवन एनी वर्क एंड इफ योर टीचर विल टेल यू दैट दिस इज सपोज टू बी डन बाय दिस मेथड, यू विल डू एग्जैक्टली द सेम मैनर. बट इफ वी विल गिव यू एनी वर्क फॉर डूइंग and we will tell you that you can do this work according to your own, using your own brain, your own methods. So here we will find more creativity among the children. Here we are giving them more scope for the purpose of development. So this is happening in the decentralization also. Decentralization mein aap delegate to kar rahe ho decision making power ko, but we are giving freedom to the employee to do that work, to take the decision according to their own judgment, right? So what is happening here? They will face certain challenges, and according to these challenges, they will develop the solutions. So what is going to happen here? Again, we are increasing their potentiality, or in future, they can also become a leader here. So decentralization also help for the development of initiative among subordinates. Now the next advantage say, it develop managerial talent for the future purpose. It is linked with the first advantage only, children, jahan pe humne kaha tha ki develop karta initiative among subordinate ko. So decentralization mein basically kya hai, if in case in future we need to make somebody as a leader, we need to provide that person training first. But in the decentralization policy, organization which is having or which is following the decentralization policy, where the authorities are delegated to the lower level of organization, what is every individual or the every subordinate is habitual of doing work according to his own creativity. They have been given more scope
for using their own experience and gaining the advantage from there. So here they all have a chance to prove their abilities, right? Because we are not sticking them according to our own method. हम उन्हें freedom दे रहे हैं काम को करने की, decision take लेने की उनके according, right? So here the judgment area will also develop, right? They can able to prove their abilities also. They can able to prove their qualifications also. Or in this manner, what can happen? We will be able to develop the futures leaders also. We will be able to develop the managerial talent for the purpose of future also. Now this is the second advantage. Now let's see the third, quick decision making, a very important advantage of decentralization. In case we are going with the decentralization here, what is happening? The decision making power are quickly taken because they don't need to ask from one to another level, right? But in case of centralization, if any decision has been taken, that flow from one to another level of chain, then another to next level of chain, because the communication is flow chain wise, which took more time. So even for the decision implementation also take time, or decision making also take time. But in case of decentralization, it decision can be taken easily because that authority is already delegated to the lower level organizations, and it can be implemented also easily and quickly. Right, so let's see what is written here. The management hierarchy can be looked upon as a chain of communication. Chain of communication, we have already done top level, middle level and lower level. If there is any decision has been taken, it has to be taken from top level, then it is informed to middle level, and then it come to the lower level. Right, so here it took time. After getting the feedback of all the labels and then taking a decision took time, right? So quick decision making nahi ho sakti hai where there is a chain of communication. Means we are talking about centralized policy, jahan pe centralization policy use hoti hai organization mein, right? But in case of decentralization policy, it reduce the decision making speed, right? And it can be, if we have decentralized, if we have already delegated the authority power, the decision can be taken into every level or any level, right? And when the decision are taken, there is no requirement from approval from each and every level. So here what is going to happen? The decision making will be done more faster in comparison to the centralizations. Now next is relief to top management. Another very important advantage of decentralization here is that decentralization diminish the amount of direct supervision exercised by superior over the activity of a subordinate, because they are given the freedom to act and decide albeit within the limit set by the superior, right? So what is happening here? How the top management is getting relief, relax after decentralization policy? Because decentralization mein kya ho raha hai, direct supervision is not there, or it is reduced. Why? That once the authority has been delegated to the lower level organization, the superior does not need to directly supervise the work of subordinate. They have been given freedom to decide to act according to the limit which is set by the superior, right? So here what superior can do? Superior can give his more work or more time to the other important work, instead of giving more time of wasting, or instead of wasting more time on the supervision of subordinate. Now next is facilitates growth. Now this is the another advantage of decentralization, which say decentralization awards greater autonomy to the lower level of management as well as divisional or departmental head. This allow them to function in a manner best suited for their department and foster a sense of competition among the department. Now how decentralization is facilitating growth? Kaise decentralization growth ko facilitate kar raha hai? Just because of the decentralization, there is more freedom has been given to the lower level of management. There is greater autonomy there, right? So every department or every divisions are completely free to take their decision on their own basis, on their own judgment. They don't need to ask each and everything from the top level. That much freedom has been given to the every department or every divisions. Now what is going to happen? Just because of this freedom, it is going to allow them function according to the best suited method for their own department and own divisions. And here even the competition is also going to increase, where the department head is knowing that if
I'm going to get a positive output, it will be completely my responsibility, right? If I am going to get any negative result, it is also going to be my responsibility. I am the one who is answerable for all those things. So what is going to happen? There will be a proper competition between different department available inside the organization, because top management ne kya kar diya hai, apna jo decision making authority thi wo kya kar di, delegate kar di hai. So just because of this competition, what will happen? The productivity level will increase, right? Productivity level increase ho jayegi and we will be able to generate more return, right? And this is what, if you are able to increase your productivity level in the organizations, if you are able to generate more return in the organization, it means you will be able to expand your business, you will be able to work in your business in a smooth manner. Now the next advantage, say better control. Better control basically say that decentralization make it possible to evaluate performance at each level, and the department can be individually held accountable for their own result. Now in case of centralization, the departments are made, divisions are made, but the whole answerability, the things, if output ka accountable kaun hai, the top management is accountable for the output of every division or every department. That was happening in the centralization policy. And just because of this, because a top management has to go with each and every department, he has to supervise each and every department, each and every division, he is not able to control them betterly, right? Because he was overburdened. Now, because of the decentralization policy, hey, every department has been given freedom to work according to their own manner, and they are the one who are accountable for their result also. So, hey, we will have more organizational objective for achieving. We will be able to contribute more. They will be able to contribute more betterly in the organization objective. And hey, the feedback from all level help us for the proper growth of proper operations also. So here what is happening? We will be able to do better control, because there will be one person who will be responsible for the control of only one department. In case of centralization, there is one top management who is responsible for the control of the whole department and division. So the control is not good there. Children, this is all about your decentralization. Now, in a conclusion, I again want to say that in spite of its benefit, decentralization should be applied with caution, as it can lead to organization disintegration. This is very important. It means decentralization policy has lots of advantage, but instead of having the advantage also, we have to be very careful during the time of decentralizing or during the time of delegating the authority toward the lower level of organization. As a top management, we have to be very careful that what are the central point of decision for our organization, what kind of authority should be retained with us only, which are the focus point to the top management, and what are the other point of authority which we can delegate. So conclusion is again saying the same thing, that we should not delegate, we should not decentralize each and every authority or each and every power making or decision making power to the lower organization. That has to be decided very carefully, that what should be decentralized and what should be centralized into the organization. Now, the last topic of this chapter is delegation and decentralization. Now, as in the beginning also I've told you that these two terms are always where the children get confused, especially in case of case study. Right, because in both the term delegation also and decentralization also, what we are doing, we are sharing our work to our subordinate, right? But there is a difference between these two things. Now see how we are able to differentiate between delegation and decentralization term. So first, let's take the difference on the basis of nature. If we talk about nature basis, delegation kya hai? It's compulsory act hai. Why it is compulsory? Because it is not possible from a one top management people to see and to perform all the tasks inside the organization by its own. So he need to delegate his some of the work. That is the reason ye kya ho gaya? Compulsory act ho gaya. Because ek organization mein owner se ya top se possible nahi ho sakta hai ki wo sare kaam kar le. इसलिए उसको कंपलसरी कुछ वर्क जो कि लेस इंपॉर्टेंट होते हैं उन्हें क्या करना पड़ता है, डेलीगेट करना पड़ता है. राइट, तो इसका नेचर क्या हो गया, कंपल्सरी नेचर हो गया. नाउ व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन, डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन इज ऑप्शनल पॉलिसी. ये एक ऑप्शनल पॉलिसी है डिसीजन मेकिंग की. व्हाई? बिकॉज इट इज डन एट द डिस्क्रिशन ऑफ द टॉप मैनेजमेंट. इट इज ओनली पावर ऑफ टॉप मैनेजमेंट टू डिसाइड वेदर दे नीड टू गो विद अ डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन पॉलिसी और वेदर दे नीड टू फॉलो द सेंट्रलाइजेशन पॉलिसी. सो द डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन नेचर कैसा हो गया, ऑप्शनल हो गया, एंड द नेचर ऑफ डेलीगेशन इज कंपल्सरी. नेक्स्ट से फ्रीडम ऑफ एक्शंस. नाउ व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट डेलीगेशंस, मोर कंट्रोल बाय सुपीरियर, हेंस लेस फ्रीडम टू टेक ओन डिसीजन. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द पॉइंट ऑफ फ्रीडम ऑफ कंट्रोल, डेलीगेशन इट्स कंपल्सरी. वेयर वी आर डेलीगेटिंग आर वर्क, वी आर शेयरिंग आर वर्क, वी आर डेलीगेटिंग द पावर टू आर इमीडिएट सबऑर्डिनेट, बट स्टिल वी आर नॉट गिविंग देम मच फ्रीडम. We are checking their work also there. So they have a less freedom for taking their own decision. Now in case of decentralization, it have less control over the executive. If work has been decentralized, if it is delegated to the employee, the power has been delegated, then they will have, the top management will have less control over the executive. They will give them more freedom for their actions. Next is status. On the status basis, delegation kya hai? It is a process followed to share task. Why we need to delegate our work? We need to delegate our work for the purpose of sharing our task, sharing our work, right? But in case of decentralization, it is the result of policy decision of top management. Why we need to decentralize? We need to decentralize if the organization has made that kind of policy. Organization has a choice of either going with centralization policy or decentralization policy, right? So decentralization ka status kya hota hai? It is result of policy of a organization or top management. Next is scope. Now when we talk about delegation, I have already told you delegation ka scope kya hota hai? Narrow scope hota hai. Why it is narrow scope? Because it is limited to superior and its immediate subordinate. This is what I have explained you, that if there are 2-3 people working into organization and they three are working into different labels. Suppose A, B, C. A in top, B in middle and C in low. So in case of delegation, A can only delegate its work to B, his immediate subordinate. He cannot delegate his work to directly to C, right? So that is the reason, because the work is only delegated to its immediate subordinate, that has or delegation has a narrow scope. But in case of decentralization, it has a wider scope, because he or the top management can delegate the work to any level or lowest, even the lowest level of management also. Now the purpose of delegations, why we have to go with delegations. Delegation we use to lessen the burden of a manager. And why? Because it is not possible from every manager to do each and every kind of work inside the organization. So for reducing its burden, we follow the delegation process, right? But decentralization basically we use to increase the role of subordinate in the organization by giving them more autonomy. When we will be able to increase the role of subordinate? When we will give them certain power. And how we are giving them certain power? By the help of decentralization policy, right? So when we talk about purpose of delegation, it is reducing the burden of manager, and the purpose of decentralization is for increasing the role of subordinate by giving them more freedom to work according to their own manner, so that even they can able to increase their creativity and learn from their own judgment. So children, this was all about your chapter 5, organizing. In the next video, we will be discussing about the case study of this chapter.